Fnatic and was chasing down his former teammates, and he really looked very comfortable on that champion. We'll see how he faces off against the LeBlanc. Follow away, and that trade will come to nothing in the end unless he wants to go back in for round two.
He wants it.
Oh, the tack sweep. That's going to slow Chachi down, but this Croc is angry, and he gets first blood. Solo kill up top.
What a fantastic read of Vizzy Chachi.
He's doing a vision first and then going in, but now Xerxes unspotted. Finds Power of Evil, goes in with a cask.
Speaking of going in, they combo up nice and easy and break through the barrier. Power's going down. It's Exile that grabs one. The solo laner starting to pick
with
up kills.
Macro. Fnatic played against them, and Fnatic, they talked about, hang on, Hillsong.
All right, so maybe that was stepping too far forward. This time the Great Health is popped. The ultimatum goes in. Kakao gets a revenge kill. So before he
engages all the time, you can overextend. I think it's mainly just on Hillsong, though, but we might get more fights.
Speaking of overextensions here, Ignar and Hansama, they're going to take the Lantern out. Duel, and that is a big barrel out of Xersei. Hansama, one more hit is all it takes for Samus to get the kill, and Ignar is going down. It's a double for the AD carry of Unicorns.
They're getting everything right now.
Let's see what Misfits can do as they cover some distance on Vizichachi. Lantern bait out, and we're going to check in on bottom as Alfari gets stopped up. Hillisang flashing forward for the tongue lashing, and Alfari's in trouble. No flash available. Auto attacks and distort. Dodged out.
Take
Alfari.
It, Hilly. Leg him.
One more shot. Exile's got it in the end. Check back up top. It looks like no casualties there.
Not yet, Pyro, but they're going to fight.
Oh, three-man belly pop. Xerxes sends him flying, and Hansama down under tower. Kakao trying to kite away. Xerxes, that's why this guy's rookie of the split. Holy moly, he keeps on rolling.
He's going. Red buff, full HP, Ignar.
And Chachi's right at the back. This is going to be three kills right there. There's the flay denial, but Ignar, your days are numbered. One shot, two shot, even Xerxes picks it up on the red buff. Hook does not connect. Okay. And they're going to turn for this. In comes Xersei and Hillisang.
Whoops!
Chachi gets blown up, though, a second too early. And now Unicorn held on the Baron, but they're getting cold feet. Hillisang wants to dive right into the back. There's the box, but they got a three-man belly pop again. And Samix just unloads a calling onto Misfits. They're melting through, but Power's untouched on the side. And now Xersei's got to get out. Chachi's down.
Oh,
Misfits turn the fight around. This is going to be a big one. Power of Evil. We've seen him chase people down on this Corki before. He gets Hillisang. He's looking for Samix. Xerxes trying to cover the escape.
The Misfits actually did it. They walked in. The Unicorns were so confident they could just deliver this belly slap in the middle of the team with the Tom Kent.
Didn't get any kills on the double teleport. And we're then put into a pure 5-on-5. Xerxes, he's stolen a lot of barons, by the way.
Though. Let's see this. Hold on. Misfits, they got to know that. Keeping it in mind, he's getting chunked down, but the Baron is as well. He goes in. Can he get the smite?
He gets it!
Xerxes comes right back in! Fresh smite steal! No, he didn't.
They hand deliver two people.
Chachi. Back to the fight in real time. Okay, Chachi's going in. Chachi's going down. Tried to finish off Power, but he walked in without a whole lot of backup there.
And now Misfits can go.
From last week, we heard his call is pretty much in action. Consistently, and when you're on a champion like Thresh, you want to be able to do that. Alfari, he's caught, he's isolated, and with the help of Tom Kench and Gragas, he's out of there.
Yeah, another example of what is safe and what is not.
Yep. Speaking of safe, I don't think Alfari or Exile is. He's going to get chunked down, but help's on the way. Let's see if he make the play. And Vizichachi, he's going to have to slice and dice his way out. But can he get away in time? In comes Xerxes, tagging in. Samix with the heal. Keep him alive. There's redemption coming, but it might be a little too late.
Look at it.
Oh, Hansama saving his support. What a hero. And now in the bottom lane, Hillisang dies. Panic right now.
They're still on it, so Misfits around here. Exile going back to base. He does have teleport ready.
Here's Kakao. Can he turn around the steal right now? He gets an end of the line. There's a teleport coming. 1,800 damage on the Baron, but they're going to turn off and try to take the fight. They melt through Hansama. Ignar's going to flash away, but Exile's right on in. Instant exhaust. They get the channel complete. He goes in with the X-Tech, but Ignar takes him out. The damage total, it's 1-2 in favor of Unicorns.
Multiple times, it's like, ooh.
I think Baron dealt the most damage in the game.
Yeah. Oh, Ignar's caught. There's the box. Do they have the damage to finish him off? Alfari throws down one of his own. Kakao causing havoc in the back line. He stays alive. I don't know how. Samix finally finishes the job. That might be the tipping point.
Oh!
Samix has gone down. Power in the back. He'll give his life for the effort. Shutdown by Vizichachi. And Baron be damned. They're looking at mid lane.
It was honestly a beautiful teamfight. Kakao with some sweet moves over the wall. But still, Unicorns, their in-fight shot calling is what got them to the first place in Group B. This is something that cannot be understated. They switch targets when they're all...
I don't think that's very productive.
All right, so, as we said, as soon as Baron spawns, we're going to get a ton of fights. Oh, wait, now he's trying again.
Oh boy, teleport coming in.
They're coming behind him. There's two members behind right now.
Delayed flash.
That's a clone. Flash.
Yeah. There's no teleport though.
Yeah, but Chachi, that's not a clone for sure. He gets instant exhausted, but look at the health bars. They're going low. They're going down. Or are they right now? Exile is popping off. And that's a double kill. Looking for more. Samix gets one. Alfari's not living very long through all that. Triple kill for the LeBlanc. Unicorns marching for base.
And suddenly we're back 30 minutes ago where the Unicorns of Love are winning every fight, running over Misfits. Took them some time, but in the end, they got that fight they were looking for.
Fantastic teleport by Visit Chachi. If Renekton at this point in the game can find the back line, find Hansama with Lantern on cooldown and no access to Blast Cone, it's over for the Misfits.
Oh boy, the longest game either. These teams have played all split long, and it is the start of a best of five. Let's go fountain diving. Why the hell not? They take down Ignar. They're getting themselves the last Nexus turret. That's the ace. That's the base. And this is game one to Unicorns. What a barn burner!
He was saying to maybe even just play Exhaust. Just locked him down a bit more.
I mean, it's going to be very hard for Xerxes to gank cause of it, but he wanted to just get the wave pushing so he can roam in with Xerxes to challenge Kakao on the Raptors.
Oh dear. Gets Kakao that smite off. Kakao, he's in trouble, but power's there. The defense saves his life for now. Hold on a second. They want to start the fights early. That's first blood for Exile right on the pool, and now it is a 2v1 over. Exile's going down. Power gets one. Can he get two?
Oh, oh my God!
Double kill for Power!
He got the blue buff!
Fire goes out, and there's the equalizer. No flash on the fizz, but the fish is there. End of the line. Collateral damage, and Chachi finishes the job.
Fari. He's actually being set up by Fari.
Chachi is roaming to the mid lane here. Oh, he's won a surprise power. Vivil here, his old teammate. A little visit here. Look above him, above power.
I mean, he gets a kill before it even begins, and now Chachi has no teammates here. Kakao wants to go in now. All of a sudden, Hillisang, Xerxe, tag it in. Glacial Fissure's up. They're looking for Power of Evil. Fish is on. Doesn't connect. Turn for Hillisang. Alfari getting the kill. Misfit snap the jump.
We're 15 minutes in, and Unicorns, they're looking to try and come back in. Maybe use a bit of that. Oh, boy. Hillisang, a little bit of damage there, but Samix tags in. They got the Glacial Fissure. Wild Gross there. Hansama, he's still got a flash, and he might just have to use it. Waiting for Kakao to blast Cone on. Over, turn it on to Xerxe, blows back with the collateral damage.
There's a teleport above from Visit Chachi.
Here we go, he's coming in this time. He's got the equalizer, he throws it down.
Ignar
flashes right on into him. Exhaust is not gonna do a thing. Samix claims the kill. Exile was dead in the midst of all that, though.
Yeah, he died in the fizz there. Doesn't matter that he has no flash.
I don't know about that one. He jumps in, unbreakable no more, and Kakao, he's got a kill.
They turn him into a frog, gave him a little kiss.
They're sending him in first. Be like, you got the sidestone, you go check and
power,
get the water.
Power, oh, he's shut down now. Let's see what else they can get off of it. Exile,
where's your macro now, DeFizio?
Yeah, I don't know. But this is again why it's so important. Push mid first, and then have that slow push.
Oh, Hillisang, he can't go anywhere right now. Tries to get the ult off, he just can't sink it. Misfits get one, can they get more? Exile being chased down, tanking up the ace in the hole. Now there's a teleport incoming from
aggressive push by the Unicorns.
Are we gonna see a Caitlyn flank on the way?
Looks like Power of Evil, he throws one ultimate, but it's a fade away and not far enough. He fades back to base.
The short ult is here with him. He's going for another one, though. That's the trade of the ulti.
Let's see what he can do right there. It goes in, ignite, and redemption is going to be enough, and Xerxe is tagging in. Alfari has nowhere to go. He used Playful Trickster already, and he's out.
Love that one from Hillisang. Walking towards the bottom lane, knowing it, now giving everything over to the Unicorns of Love.
Yeah, that's why we saw that stat earlier. Unicorns going in with another decisive engage here.
Exile had that big ulti off, and they're going to destroy Hansama with the last pop of the Hemo Plague onto second-tier tower. Kakao
is the best chess player in the European LCS.
Yeah. Doesn't say a whole lot, but he is.
Yeah.
I mean, Perks is his competition, so...
Yeah. Hey. He's also a former Age of Mythology.
Chachi is going to open up the opportunity for Unicorns to take something out of the base. That's a quick inhibitor. Those two Mountain Drakes... Oh boy.
They're on the way.
Oh, blue trinket here. Kakao's coming in one more time. Hillisang blocking. Doesn't know exactly where he is. He goes in. The steal's not happening this time. And that's a dead kitty cat. Unicorns getting in. Can they get out? Samix is caught. Playful Trickster Alfari looking for a kill off the back half of this one.
The ball has been placed, but not far forward enough. Alfari's worm once again. And oh my goodness, that's down to half health. In goes the fish. Unicorns, can they peel back in time? There's the ball, Power of Evil. He's looking for another place to use it. Redemption comes in. That's a lot of damage, but they have got the Elder Dragon. Exile takes out Ignar. Exile in the middle looking for Hansama here. Does he have it? He does. The double kill. The shockwave, it pulls him in. But is it too little? Is it too late? A triple kill for Exile. And down goes Alfari. Unicorns charging for base.
And that was the fight they were looking for with the Elder Drake. Chachi, he wants more.
Oh, he does. He's stopped by the ball, but that's fine. He's okay. Here.
Some great shot calling from the Unicorn. So they start the Nashor, they see Kakao, and they stop all five of them. Nobody is the idiot that keeps hitting the Baron to get it low enough for Kakao to steal. They leave it at 2.3k, and the Rengar is now at the wrong part of the fight. Orianna ulti gets used after Hansama drops, and this, again, super forward team fight for the Unicorns.
They won.
They're all European roster with so much focus on synergy and communication. It's paying off in these fights here because they're all on the same page.
Oh, they are indeed, and they will be able to take that all the way to the finish, closing out game number two. A big statement from the Unicorns, and it's match point, baby!
I don't know. This is happening. The theory behind it is that the LeBlanc will not really have kill pressure on you. You get somewhat decent wave clear, and then you
this
go to
be here because they're doing the exact same thing on the other side of the map.
Alfari's been bullied quite a lot this series.
Oh, it still
flash
hits.
For flash is still going to follow through. Alfari is in trouble. No escapes, and that's going to be first blood. It goes to Xerxes.
I flashed straight, and so went through hard.
A token Krug contest.
And he just yields. He's like, you know what? I don't need these Krugs.
I already got the first blood. You know,
Chachi could be in trouble, though. That's a lot of minions, and Alfari just solos him.
So that is now really good from his Power Weaver can actually return a lot of damage.
He missed even Q there, I think, Bauer. Now he's going in for Ignite.
Ignite!
Oh, he's dead!
What a play! Let's see if they can find the wraparound here. Kakao still looking. Chachi knows something's up. Throws the equalizer. Flashes back. Kakao is foiled. Alfari wants to finish the job. He flashes. He autos. He gets another. And they manage to make it work.
Mid lane getting pushed in right now by the Unicorns
with the Misfits.
Now they are.
All right, nails Chachi in the face. He's got no flash. He's got no life. He gets an equalizer.
Misfits
off,
last game. They were too passive in the early game.
Chachi's going to stay alive off the back of it. Flashes
he's
up
back
to both those top laners.
Chachi's back in the game.
Here we go. Unicorns trying to punish in mid, but Misfits, they're bringing more friends to the party here. Hillisang is isolated, jumped on by Kakao. That's a big wild growth. He flashes, Power gets the kill with picks.
Yeah, this utility Lulu is really paying off. Exile, who's been clearing out a lot of these side lanes.
Do you want to trade it, though, for Lockett?
Yes, I think you do.
They found Hillisang. He's going to send the hook. It just brings Power in, and Hansama with a second kill assisted by the rest of Misfits.
So he's looking for the root into Arrow, but it's still on cooldown, so root into... So,
Mantra, okay, they're going to invest a lot here. Exhaust.
Oh, Unicorns is on the way.
Down. Unicorns are incoming. This fight's a lot more than Misfits might have bargained for. Samix is going to have to flash away. And Alfari is getting the kill on that one. He turns the rest of the Unicorns back. Ignar's in trouble. This has gotten messy. Misfits incoming. Lantern pulling Xersei out, but Chachi is left. Four dead, Alfari on a rampage kill. That is two for two.
Yeah, both of them are Unicorns crushes, right?
So Chachi's grouping now, and
oh,
engage.
Oh man, they get a big old knockup, and Unicorns are caught inside the AoE of Misfits. Redemption comes in, keeping Kakao nice and healthy, but it looks like they've run smack dab out of damage in Exile. TPing in, caught out by Kakao, goes back in, chains are on, he's gonna have to walk it out, dodges a Glitter Lance, Unicorns get nobody,
Alfari.
But they're low, in comes Alfari, reinforcements have arrived. And no amount of going golden is going to save you, Chachi. Down he goes. Hansama gets one. Power on the chase. Lantern,
ooh,
he's
safe.
Out. They've got four members making their escape right now. But Power.
Inside of the pit, Ignar looking to zone around. He throws down the Blue Trinket. A Blue Trinket is thrown down, I should say. This is going too quick. It's going to be picked up by Misfits.
And a really timely engage. At the start of that.
No.
No. Yet.
Yes.
Way to go, Deficio.
Yes!
That's how they're going to counter mid lane Lulu.
Yeah, next
there we
patch.
Go. Well, it's going to be a ways away. We're still on 7.6. And Unicorns having to take a quick retreat. Kakao wanted to go in, but they've stopped Samix short as he flashes away.
Ultimate cannon!
Right under tower. Power of Evil! That's a big pick! And they're throwing down the damage right now. There was a red carpet out of Visit Chachi, but it was his...
This tower is going down.
Xerxes trying to
you're
defend,
not wrong,
there's
no.
Nothing going on.
Maybe
there.
You are wrong.
I don't know. It looks like it may take a second. Meanwhile, Alfari is soloing Exile down on the bottom. This one is all Misfits right now, and they take down Hillisang too.
Rotation coming out. Mid to bot here. Another turret falling.
They're going to be able to get this one, no problem. Mists are looking to stay alive. It was two Unicorns games. We have had some long ones, but gentlemen, this series is going to continue.
Definitely going, lurking around. Oh. Might even be worth canceling back here. Yep, just make him walk.
Oh boy, they might be able to take a 4v5 here. Chachi, he's going to pop his Zhonya's in Kakao. He's stunned up for just a second. Wild Growth keeping him alive not too long.
Kennen walked to the fight. Alfari was not split pushing. He walked to the fight.
He's even get through the base. I don't know. Chachi's there to cut him off.
I think Alfari was a little lost right there.
Yeah, just a bit. Trying to get the outplay, but it's 1v3. There's no way he's getting through this one. Stopped out.
His team is on Baron, though. Xerxes and Samix are around the Baron.
Oh, he gets a kill. He does it. Alfari gets one back. Oh, that's hashtag worth.
Oh, Nexus turret fell in the process.
The lack of control ward also removes some safety for Misfits.
Unicorns have no way to win this right
Nexus
now.
Turret
this
is solid. Oh, Nexus turret is solid. Fire's gonna do it too, man.
Autos. There's no answer right now.
And they're gonna die.
They're gonna kill him. The back door.
At least four more shots, but he's dying. He's low.
Hold on a sec. He gets a heal.
Nine hits for his spawn.
Oh, man. That was...
Chachi.
Okay, hold on a minute. Chachi is caught. Rest of Misfits are here.
All right, Xav. Teleport.
All right. Misfits.
So now they can try and fight, maybe. Can they get there in time? That's the question.
Yeah, where is Exile? This is a super slow Nashor. This teleport should have been used already.
Kakao's on the way with Kakao's the Elder coming. Drake.
It's so close.
Here he goes. Can he get in for the steal right now? Just in time, he can't get it, but now the fight is on. Kakao keeping Xerxes locked up inside the pit. He pulls the lantern out. He's going to have to flash his way to freedom. Unicorns are making it out with everybody.
Yeah, they just need to run away now. They just got...
Thrill of the hunt. Looking for Xerxes, but just out of range, and he gets hooked right back on in. There's the arrow, connects this time. Alfari in the front, so is Chachi, but the Unicorns are holding stronger. They get one.
And the Unicorns say thank you very much, and now they
pick up another
shield. Yeah, one look at
Alfari, tired of that garbage. There's an ulti.
There we go. They found Alfari himself. He might be wishing he had boots to step a little quicker this time. But Kakao jumps back in. Unicorns are still able to secure themselves a tower. But can they survive the back half of this fight? They've flown through Kakao's health bar. Misfits are running scared back to base.
For no reason. And now this is smite versus no smite. Hillsang super aggressive here.
Yeah, maybe they can turn the fight on. Alfari, though, he's able to tank through. And Hillsang is going to get taken down. Now it's a 4v3. And the rest of Unicorns are getting shut down.
Hillsang!
The
power of evil!
He's still going right now! Power wants to chase on. The arrow is going to get flashed. Oh, man. Misfits.
There are no minions.
Backdoor, it can end.
Well, they're at least going to try and get this in here. But noted, Vichachachi is alive in 1 second, and there's no minions. But there's, of course, no Nexus.
There's no Nexus.
They can win.
That's what I said. They're
going to win.
One inhibitor. They got it down.
There's Nexus.
The Unicorns are trying to defend.
They're not going
to
win.
Oh, man. This is going to be the last chance. Saloon.
Power's all forced in. They're not going to win.
Vichachachi comes up big. They're turning it right around.
Asaba.
Operation move at 48 minutes.
They're going to win. They're
going to
win.
Misfits are going to do it. It's a double kill.
Nexus,
put on your dancing shoes, because Misfits are staying alive!
It's been such a long time since we were near the Nexus. Those turrets died long time ago.
There were no minions.
Long time ago, but there was a bit of Chachi. Chachi left alive.
Unicorns left will suffer.
Yeah. I mean, they should, but on paper,
fair.
They've been surviving weak matchups really well, but this is almost taking it to
them. I think it's a good call, actually, from them, at least to try and force a
Fair
flash.
Call. They got one. Slowing Ignar. He's gonna have to force that flash out of Hansam or that heal and the flash.
Oh! That was so good by Hillsang!
Ignar, Hansam, and nowhere to go right now. They're zoned off. Let's see. One shot connects, the other doesn't. There is a big Zyra ulti, but Xerxes is coming right out of it, turning for Hansam. Chachi, power of evil. This is getting real messy as Kakao exhaust on him. Falling forward is Exile, and it looks like Misfits are coming down with a bad case of emo plague.
Yeah, it's not over yet, guys.
Hillsang said go, so everybody went. Samix now took the long journey around. Two for one so far.
Barrel knocks Exile right into the wall, but the Flourish is going to connect on power. Hillsang finding Ignar. Oh, they find him right back. Uh-oh. He's going to flash into the team. He wants to make the play. In comes Exile and Xerxes. Kakao gets an ult out of Power of Evil, but that's going out of time.
Say what you want about Hillsang. This man has no fear. He's going in again.
He definitely belongs to the frontline one.
Yeah.
He's the playmaking Tom Kench right now.
He's still there right now, and that's Xerxes can attack.
Eat him.
And Alfari. Oh, Ignar around the side, though. Zyra ulti is going to be enough. Alfari knocks him down.
It is... To be fair, though, the most classic Unicorns of Love thing. Oh, we're not done.
Xerxes wants to keep on making
Holy
the plays. That damage from Rengar trying to get to the blast cone, but he's popped again. The barrel comes down on his head.
Hillisang as a player, Unicorns of Love as a team. Makes him, never mind, they're gonna kill him.
You're not gonna get any chance
to kill him anyway.
They take down power.
No, that's true, and all honesty, it's looking great for the Unicorns to start things off as Exile looking to add his kill counter right now. Goodbye, Han Sama, and hello, Xersei, tagging his way in for Kakao.
I should not have left the base. I am sorry.
Here they go. Round two. Ignar a little bit low. Alfari, though, is the target of
choice. They're on his dead corpse.
They are on top of everything, looking at those Tier 2s as they finish off the Tier 1. However, Chachi does get shut down.
The Misfits are...
Bottom Misfits fight, though.
Have recognized the threat here. Chachi, 1v3, no way he's gonna get one out of this. They respect it, but Alfari in the end finishes him off. That was a lot of damage he was dealing.
Not been getting quick enough towards her items, and her team is just losing around her.
Ignar, I don't know how he stayed alive that long, to be honest, but Exile just gets himself a fifth, then he gets out, courtesy of Hillisang. I was trying to save Deficio here, stop laughing, Crepo.
Hey, I'm not doing anything,
hold on a second. Invulnerable for just a second. Exile, though, is still on the chase. He won't play, but now he's being turned back around. He just can't close the
damage.
That's disgusting.
Exile still gets the kill. They get everything. Kakao's going down. Unicorns want this big time.
And this must make Sheepy
zero on this Vladimir.
Like, they're on the verge of heading into Hamburg to play the finals against G2. And not even that much as an underdog.
Stage where you had to just kind of get used to it if you're the Unicorns of Love, and they've corrected so many mistakes and they're going in.
Yeah, they want to try to end this one as early as possible right now. In goes Chachi right into the back line. Exile coming up legendary. And everything's looking peachy for the Unicorns as they're trying to drive through into the base. Misfits are melting.
It's only 23 minutes and a half into game and Inhip is falling and they may just go for the final push. What a dominating performance here from the Unicorns.
Back-to-back huge long games that went real late. Lots of scaling on all sides, but it has not lacked for action. One Nexus turret's gonna fall. Unicorns are gonna find themselves another Ignar and Alfari trying to hold the line here.
They got Ansama alive. He's on his way to try and defend, but the Nexus turret, it's right open.
That's all they gotta do. They just need a few more autos, but they are going to back off. Those death timers are not long.
A few times
a conventional macro. They definitely do use macro, but they seem to do the conventional closing ability here in the late game. Exile going in.
They might just be able to dive it all in. It started off. Exile, though, he's got no more pool left, but he does have some backup. They may get the shutdown, but will it be enough? Misfits low on the health bars. The curtain call is calling, and that's going to be a few more taken out. Alfari.
Of course, it's Hillisang back there.
That's the only one's
left. Hillisang's back there in Nexus alone.
The double kill. That's it. It was a big series, but Unicorns will not be denied, and they are headed to the finals. 2 years in the making!
I mean, just so well...
Place your bets on more than 15 esports games. Deposit and withdraw easily using many worldwide payment methods. Place your bets live while enjoying the game. We offer 24/7 support and bonuses for every new user. Bet now on arcanebet.com.
Unicorns of Love, they've been in every single playoff since they joined the LCS. They made the final in the very first split. They were here, and now they're back after showing the best split.
No one can take this away from the Unicorns. They completely deserve this spot.
It's really nice. Good job, guys. Really, really proud.
Victory words with the team.
One more series against G2. Let's do our best.
And G2 will have to fear their horns.
1, 2, 3, US!
This is going to be one hell of a final in Hamburg.
It's going to be such a fun final to watch. Because Unicorns of Love will make sure there's going to be some fast-paced
Sheepy League of Legends. In his hometown, he'll crank up the spice for that one.
Oh, I think so.
The funny thing is, you know, we call Unicorns of Love one of the best team-fighting teams in Europe, but G2 is right up there. Yeah. Like, it's going to be such a fun game to watch with some very... very gifted players.
They're definitely top two. Like, whether you rank G2 first
top two, 100%.
Or Unicorns of Love, top two in terms of just raw, sheer team fighting ability. Both these teams belong there.
Team fighting reigns supreme. Seems to be the case in this spring split so far. And, you know, we have got an epic matchup on our hands. I'm surprised that Romain chose that attire today. But that's
I think he's going to save that for Hamburg.
Possibly. So, all in all, for Unicorns of Love, like 2-0, they get ahead. They lose that third game to a good draft from Misfits.
But they're about to win it, too.
Sure. Yeah. They actually were coming back in that game. Then they take down this one here, 26 minutes. Didn't care about the kill counter pick at all. The lanes that were supposed to lose in the bot lane were actually going even. Really well played by Samax and the guys, and Exile, of course. I just think also if you're Misfits, like, sucks that you're losing this one, but today you weren't the better team.
No.
And,
no.
And you can still be so happy and proud of your very first split in the LCS. You're still gonna play for third place.
Yeah, and next week you can be the better team. Still a similar matchup where they would go up against like the Unicorns Light in Fnatic for that third place match.
Well, they've clearly been trained for that one, yeah. And it is rough for Misfits, but the goal for that team was to make the semifinals.